Alf White was a really fascinating character because he was Darby Sabini's, who was the sort of, you know, I mean, a lot of people might know that from the Peaky Blinders. They touch on Darby Sabini in that, but, you know, I think he's a little bit too fictionalised about who he really was and what he was about. And Alf White was his sort of partner. And so they were the main guys in Clerkenwell and North London. And then all of a sudden you've got the young upstarts coming along, and as everything is secular in that world. You know, the new people, younger, hungrier guy comes and takes over. But they still kept control of it. And he was a fascinating, well-respected man, Alf White, yeah. So I was very honoured to play him, yeah. You've got the 30s, you're coming out of depression. You've got young guys really getting a lot of money for the first time. The streets were paved with gold for them if you had the nerve to go out and take it, and these guys did, you know. So I think it's a fascinating slice of London social history that's not been touched on before, and I think that's where it's going to stand out, and it's going to be a cut above the others, yeah.
It's a fantastic British cast alongside you. Can you talk a little bit about what it was like working with the rest of them, and particularly, I mean, Leo's performance, because it's great work from him.
Well, Terry and I have worked together a few times now, I'm very pleased to say, and I think he's fabulous in this film. And Leo's an old mate. We worked together. He's my little Leo, because I've worked with him when he was a lot younger. And so when you're an old boy like me, you've been about a few years, you see him all coming along, you know. And Leo's a fabulous little actor, and he's a really good actor. And he brings a real good charm and elegance to the part as well, which Billy Hill had in abundance, yeah, evidently, yeah.